Hello friends, welcome back. In this video we are going to talk about web service best practice. In the last video we have done some implementation, we have done some web service examples, we have done a CRUD operation using H2 in-memory database. Okay, those are working very well, but we have not focused on what is the best practice of web service implementation. Okay, now in this video we are going to explore that. The first point, creating endpoint as readable. That meaning, when someone sees your endpoint, someone sees your URL, that URI, that should be understandable. Okay, this endpoint for post creating a resource, this endpoint for deleting a resource, this endpoint for fetching a resource. Like that, the consumer should understand our endpoint by reading the endpoint. Okay, so we have to make our endpoint readable. So this is the standards for creating a endpoint. Okay, use plurals in your endpoint while access your resource. We already did that in the last example itself. We already did that while getting all the product, we are using products. Okay, while getting all the products, we are using products. While we viewing particular product, we are passing a product type. Okay, so we are following this one already. Third one is, when you add a plural word in your endpoint, use only nouns. Don't use action name like create product, update product. In this example, in the post mapping, whenever add new product in my database, I used here add, right? That is wrong. That is not a standards as per the RESTful. We need to use the resource name. We need to use the resource name as a plural, then we need to use some post mapping. That meaning you are adding a new product. Okay, that meaning you are adding a new product. So these points we almost followed already. Okay, what is next one? Web service endpoint should properly associate with correct HTTP methods and the HTTP code. What is that? Here I am not doing anything. What I am doing, I am adding a post mapping, then implementing a one method. Inside a method, I am calling a one service method. That service method saving the product in my database. That's it, right? In this particular endpoint, I am not using any HTTP codes. I am not using any HTTP codes. We need to use. These are the HTTP methods I am using already, but HTTP code, status code, I am not using. Let's see how to do that. Let's see how to handle HTTP status code. According to this method, I am not handling anything here. When you look at a postman, whenever add a product, you will, in the response section, you will receive a one status code called 200. That meaning it's a success. After sending a request, our server adding some product to the database, then give the response back to 200 and OK. That meaning your call is success. Okay. But here, when you look at here, I am not doing anything. By default, it's giving the 200. Very important thing is, whenever you implement one web service method, web service endpoint, that web service must return response body, must return response body, HTTP response body. I am not returning here anything. I am not returning anything here. Okay, I am just returning a void. How to return a HTTP response body? There is one class called response entity saying that void. That meaning this response body does not have anything. Okay, after saving the record, I want to give some correct status code. So far we received 200 and okay. That meaning it's success. Since we are using post mapping, whenever you use post mapping, you are adding some resource to in the database. You are adding some resource. In our case, product is a resource. Okay, that product we are adding to the database. Once you added, or once you created a product in the database, you need to send a status code as a created. Status code as a created. That is the perfect one. Here I am going to return new response entity HTTP status dot created. That's it. Now, after saving my product, I am sending a response body with created state. With the created state, that meaning your product created successfully. Let's see the example now. I'll go to add this one. Oh, I need to restart. Before that, I need to restart. Since I added the some code. Okay, I'll going to run this method. See here, status 201 created. Previously, we always get 200 okay. That means success. Call is success. Here in this call, it's saying that whatever resource you are sending from the client side, that resource created successfully in your database. That is the meaning here. So this is a correct HTTP status code for post mapping. Whenever you want to create any resource through post mapping, that time we have to send a response body with status code as a 201. That is the correct one. Okay, now if something went wrong, for example, when you add a product, you did some mistake, that time definitely server give a error, product never create. In that situation, how to handle, what kind of status code you're going to return to the consumer, that I'll going to see, that we're going to see now. For example, I'll miss to add a product price. I missed to add a product price. Now I'm going to send a request. Still it say created under 201. Let's see what's going on in the database. See, the first row I created with the price, it's added. The second item, chocolate, I missed to add a product price, but it's coming as a null value, right? That is wrong. I need to validate. We need to validate these values are coming to database. Okay. We should not allow to store null value. Okay. This product price must have some value. Product name must have some value. Stock code must have some value. Three columns are mandatory. So we need to prevent adding a null value first. In the entity object is a product object, we can add one parameter called nullable equal to false. That meaning product name never null. I'll going to add all the column, all the attribute. I'll going to restart my application. Whenever change, we have to restart. There is a way not restart. Even if you change, we don't have to restart the server. For that, we need to do something that I have not done. That's the reason I'm restarting. Okay. Now your database get vanished when you say here. See, since I restarted, nothing is there. Now again, I'm going to send this request without product price. Let's see what's happening. Now I got an error. I have not added the product price. So server giving the response with the error statement. It says status equal to 500, status equal to 500 and internal server error, internal server error. When you look at the database log, sorry, in the server log, what is saying it? Not null property reference a null or transient value from the product price, from the product object in the product price attribute. According to this statement, product price cannot be null value, cannot be null value. That the reason your JPI return error, JPI return error, that error coming like this here, internal server error. When you look at this error, what you think? Some problem with server, that's the reason server not able to add the product. Okay, when you look at the error, we are feeling like this only. If a customer see the read the error, hey, server has got some problem, that's the reason I am not able to add the product. They will say, right? But problem is where? Problem is the request. The consumer not adding the product price. That is the reason server not able to add the product. It's written by default internal server error. Okay, we should not allow this kind of error. We need to tell to the consumer, hey, you missed this particular attribute, please add. That is the correct error, right? Also, we should not give the 500 status code. Okay, 500 status code for internal server error. We should not do. We have to set correct status code. We have to set a correct error message. Let's see how to do that. Go to stock management controller. Try. Catch exception. Catch exception, then we need to say return new response entity HTTP status equal to bad request. Okay, let's see how this validation is coming now. Now according to this code, after successful saving product, I am setting the status also created. If any error occurs, I am saying bad request. I am saying a bad request. Server is started now. I'm going to send. See, I am not getting any message here because I am handling here. That's the reason it's not giving any message. I am just returning response entity. Status code as a bad request. Status code as a bad request. When you click this bad request, what it's saying? Bad request equal to 400. Message is bad request. So when you look at the client side, say 400 bad request. Now at least we include something now in the case of handling the error. When I miss some product, when I send a request, our server returning, hey, you did bad request. So I'm not able to add the product. That is a client can, but still client cannot understand this. Client still can, because I'm not sending some valid error message. I'm sending only code, 400 code. That meaning it's a bad request. Something's bad happened in your request. The meaning is something bad happened in your request. That's the reason not able to add the product. I'm stopping video here. In the next class, we're going to explore how to give exact error message, how to give exact validation error message, and how to handle generic exception handling in the web service. Please subscribe if you are not yet. Share this video to your friend circle. Click bell icon for regular updates. Thank you so much for watching this full video. Until next video, bye bye from Suresh K7.